Mr. Speaker, distinguished honorable members of the Lagos State House of Assembly, our dear political leaders, you will recall that on Monday, 24th of August 1999, I presented before this Honorable House the 1999 Supplementary Appropriation Bill, which was signed into law on Monday, 4th of October of 1999. That same event became expedient at that time because the approved 1999 budget was not completely in tune with the policy thrust of this administration, having been prepared by FY military administration. Today, I have the honor and privilege once more to present this honor, to this honorable house, the year 2000 budget, which happened to be the first full budget in the life of this administration. The year 2000 budget is also significant, as it is, it provides the platform to transform the manifesto of our great party into reality. This budget ushers us into a new millennium in which several people have placed high hope and expectation of better life ahead. Hence, we must find our way to prosperity. Against this backdrop, this administration is well poised to eliminate poverty and enhance economic development through provision of basic needs and infrastructure. Accordingly, the underlying objective of the year 2000 budget is a vigorous pursuit of poverty alleviation and programs that will impact greatly on the lives of the people. Government intends to focus on early deliverables, free education, job creation, free and sustainable health care, etc., etc. Government is also resolved to meet the challenges of the nefarious activities of men of the underworld through the provision of substantial allocation of funds to enhance and protect the protection of life and property. Equally significant is the provision of necessary wherewithal to the judiciary in order to expeditiously dispense justice. In the preparation of the year 2000 budget, also is the outcome of the extensive consultation with the private sector on the policies and programs of this administration. Before proceeding further, permit me to give a brief account of the 1999 budget performance, especially as it relates to the activities of government within the last 6 months. The 1999 budget at present. Consequent upon the 1999 supplementary appropriation law, the initial state budget of 14.200 billion was revised upward to 17.884 billion. An analysis of the overall budget size of 17.884 billion for the 1999 revealed that the sum of 12.00 billion, 67.3%, was appropriated to recurrent programs, that is, i.e., personnel and overhead costs, while the sum of 5.835 billion, representing 32.75%, was earmarked for capital expenditure. I'll view the charts as attached to the documents. Furthermore, out of the prorated budget provisions of 13.383 billion for the 9 months, a total sum of 10.248 billion was expended, resulting in an overall budget performance of 76.6%. Ordinary revenue. The performance of ordinary revenue in the first 9 months of 1999 was 8.361 billion against the prorated expectation of 10.908 billion, representing 76.65%. The highest contribution to the ordinary revenue collected over 9 months was made from taxes, fines, and licenses, which brought in 6.015 billion, or 71.9%. The contribution of statutory allocation came next with an absolute figure of 2.191, or 26.2%. Personnel costs. In the 1999 budget, an amount of 4.289 billion was earmarked for staff salaries and allowances, but was later increased to 5.324 billion through supplementary appropriation. Out of this amount, a total sum of 4.128 billion has been expended as at September 1999, which is made up of 1.905 billion for civil service salary and allowances and 2.223 billion for teachers' emoluments. This represents about 103.4% of the prorated figure for the period under consideration. In fact, as at November of 1999, a total amount of 5.243 billion has been expended on staff salaries. If this figure is projected, it is expected by the end of the year 1999, an amount of 5.720 billion will have been expended, thus leaving a shortfall of 396 million to be filled by way of additional supplementation. Furthermore, to be able to accommodate the 25% end of the year bonus approved for the public servants, additional provision of 107 million will be required. To that extent, the total required additional supplementation will stand at 503.6 million for that year. Overhead costs. The total revised provision. I'm not going to be dealing with the charts that maybe you've seen either at the bottom or the top of your, I leave you to look into that. Overhead costs. The total revised provision for the overhead cost was 6.8685 billion, out of which 3.555 billion, representing 70.9% of the prorated figure of 5.013 billion, has been expended in the period under review. After taking the above into account, a sum of 7.683 billion was spent on recurrent expenditure against an estimate of 9.007 billion, which resulted in a performance of 85.30% during the period under review. From the foregoing, a sum of 7.683 billion was spent on recurrent expenditure against an estimate of 9.007 billion, which has resulted in a performance of 85.30% during the period under review. Against this background, the total recurrent expenditure is projected to stand at 10.244 billion at the end of the year of 1999. Capital receipts. The performance of capital receipts is commendable. A sum of 5.416 billion has been collected as of September 1999 out of the overall target of 5.835 billion. The performance is mainly due to substantial extra receipts from the federal government in the following respects. Aggressive reconciliation with federal government accounts brought in 1.2 billion additional. Environmental grants for Nigeria 99.05 billion. Ecological grants 0.75 billion. Shares of recovered loot, 0.125 billion. And a strat for performance of capital receipts of 1999. Our capital expenditure. The total capital budget allocation for 1999 was 5.70 billion. Out of which, as at September, an amount of 2.6 billion was spent. This represents 61.9% of the prorated figure of 4.28 billion for the month. During the year, a number of important projects were executed, some of which are highlighted below. Rehabilitation of secondary schools, provision of school furniture, release of counterpart funds to the World Bank for the Health System Fund, $55 million, road rehabilitation and maintenance, launching of microcredit scheme for farmers and fishermen, construction of additional police posts, that's for about 38.38 million, commissioning of public estate Okuoba, and it laid a foundation of the Millennium Housing Scheme, known to the GRA. The year 2000 budget, which I tag as the budget of prosperity. At this juncture, I now present the high point of the year 2000 budget to be known as budget of prosperity. The proposed overall size of Lagos State budget for the year 2000 is 42.228 billion. This is made up of 27.688 billion recurrent expenditure and 14.5 40 billion in capital expenditure. You will observe that this is higher than the 1999 revised budget of 17.44 billion by 135%. Mr. Speaker and honorable members of the House, the proposed budget size of over 40 billion is unprecedented in the history of Lagos State. This quantum leap is a manifestation of our conviction that it is the only way to achieve true economic takeoff. As earlier stated, we must fund and spend our way to economic prosperity. This time around, with our newfound democracy, our people must be truly emancipated from the poverty trap of so many years. In the pursuit of the objective, of this objective, therefore, priority attention is to be given to the underlisted area. One, road construction and rehabilitation. Two, energy, that is electricity. Three, water supply. Four, environment and housing, including flood control and waste management. Security of lives and property. Six, transportation and traffic management. Seven, improvement of educational facilities and standards. Eight, sustainable health care delivery services. Nine, well-funded staff welfare package. Ordinary revenue. A total sum of 31.30 billion ordinary revenue is projected for collection during the fiscal year 2000. The breakdown shows that the sum of 22.72 billion or 77.3% is expected from the internally generated revenue, IGR, and 8.759 billion or 22.7 from statutory allocations. 22.7% from statutory allocations. The 31.306 billion total ordinary revenue is 115% higher than the revised 1999 approved budget of 14.544 billion. The revenue projection is predicated on a number of factors, among which are, one, more effective and prudent financial management through an overhaul in internal control mechanism and elimination of leakages and waste. Two, effective policing and management of all revenue sources. We believe that we diversify and deepen the revenue net. Three, the state, as permissible under physical federalism, is reintroducing the collection of sales tax. However, it will be on a selective basis. This will be on luxury goods and services and other specific items. The proceeds will be used in developing key infrastructure such as new roads, hospitals, revenue management, and security enhancement. The Ministry of Finance has been charged with the responsibility of working out modus operandi accordingly. Four, the state government will introduce property taxes as additional source of revenue. Five, extensive consultation with major revenue generating agencies, particularly the Board of Internal Revenue and Land Bureau, with the understanding that adequate provision has been made for necessary vehicles and equipment. Four, out of the expected collection of 22.72 billion revenue from internal sources, an amount of 13.065 billion is anticipated from taxes due to expected increase in pay arising from likely upward review of wages. Seven, statutory allocation is projected to go up over threefold on the account of healthier oil prices projected in year 2000 and more transparent distribution of federally collected revenue. Eight, earnings and sales increased from 663.19 million in 1999 to about 5.41 billion in year 2000. Personnel costs. A total of 15.514 billion is proposed for the payment of salaries and allowances and pensions in the financial year 2000, which is 191.14% higher than the 5.32 billion budgeted in 1999. This sharp increase over 1999 figure is as a result of an emphasis of a review of either the salary of an allowance, if there is any deregulation of the petroleum products, as well as additional recruitment, the expansion within subsectors and departments of our various ministries. Overhead costs. A total sum of 12.028 billion has been budgeted for overhead costs in year 2000, resulting in 79.93 increase when compared with the 1999 revised provision of 6.85. The major increase largely attributed to the need to provide financial backing for the newly introduced policies in areas of education, health, poverty alleviation, rural development and job creation, traffic management and road decongestion, etc., etc. Capital receipts. The major components of capital receipts are expected to increase substantially in year 2000. The expectation from value-added tax is 4.21 billion, which is 31% higher than the 1999 budget of 3.2 billion. These figures was arrived at after due consultation with the National Planning Commission, NPC. On grant and reimbursement, an amount of 325 million is budgeted for collection from allottees' capital contribution to the provision of infrastructure in Lekki Peninsula, Parkview, and other estates. It is also expected that the sum of 5.884 billion and 500 million will be sought as internal and external loans, respectively, to finance of viable projects such as water, waste management, sport, housing and transport, etc., etc. Moreover, the loans, to the extent possible, will be used to fund projects that have a productive nature and will pay their way, thereby free up the scarce budgetary resources in funding core social services. Year 2000 capital budget. The year 2000 capital budget has a total size of 14.5 billion, which represents an increase of 149.19% over the 1999 capital budget of only 5.835 billion. Government, in the year 2000, we pay particular attention to road construction and maintenance, which explains the allocation of 2.8 billion, or 19.25% of the total capital budget size to this sector. Such roads include the Ikoto-Idodo road, Iju Akute Elliot Road, Magidu Ipakodo Road, Ipakodo, to mention just a few. I must emphasize here that all local governments will benefit from this exercise. So if you don't hear, the name of your local government, don't go back. And education we attract a substantial proportion of the capital budget because of the free education policy of the government, particularly in the areas of additional classroom construction and refurbishment of existing schools and supply of school quality. Tertiary institutions have an allocation of 1.3 billion to spend on various capital expenditure projects to improve dilapidated and inadequate infrastructure. The lives of our students must improve for the better. Furthermore, government will pay attention to urban renewal and in particular address reclining decay of the business district. My conclusion. Before I conclude this presentation, I wish to reiterate that this administration, this is ultimate to involve all stakeholders in the economy, particularly the larger spectrum of the private sector, and will continue to do so throughout the life of this administration. We have come to the realization that government alone cannot unilaterally deliver the goods. The collective effort of government and these stakeholders will surely carry us to our desired goals and objectives. Mr. Speaker, respected members of the State House of Assembly, the budget that has been presented summarizes policies and programs designed to achieve the collective aspiration of this state in year 2000. It is regarded as our launching pad to economic prosperity. While commending this to a thorough scrutiny by the House, I wish to solicit your support in its expeditious consideration and approval. I wish you a Merry Christmas, Ramadan Kareem, Eid al-Fitr separate celebration, and prosperous year 2000 and beyond. Thank you, and God bless you.